Welcome to this video 5 in the series Learning Finance Can Be Fun. In this video, I'm going to deal with two important sources of finance, namely equity and debt. Friends, broadly, there are two categories of sources of finance. One, we could call them as direct source, and another, indirect source. What is this direct source? Direct sources of finance are those who associate with the business to finance it. That's their objective. They have no other business interest. They want to finance this company, this entity, and therefore they get associated with the entity. The other category, which is indirect sources of finance, they get associated for a business reason. For instance, there could be a vendor who supplies goods. There could be an employee who wants to render one's own services and talent. Now, indirectly, sometimes they happen to finance the entity, and we are going to discuss about these indirect sources in a separate video. For now, I am going to restrict my discussion. So, when we talk about direct sources of finance, broadly, we speak about two categories. The ones that I mentioned on the title slide, debt and equity. So, what is debt? Debt simply means that we borrow money from someone who is willing to lend money to us at a defined rate of interest. Equity, on the other hand, is like seeking someone else's money as an investment, not by way of lending the money, but by way of investing. And we are going to see the difference between these two categories in the next slide. So when people want to put their money to work, they could wear either of the two hats. They could wear the hat of an investor who wishes to be a part of the business, who wants to be a part owner of the business. On the other hand, the lender is one who is not interested in being an investor, but rather is willing to provide debt. In other words, lender is someone who is willing to lend a sum of money for a defined consideration. So there is a difference in the expectation of investors and lenders. Investors look for capital appreciation. They hope that the money that they invest grows in multiples. They would share a part of the profits. And as the value of the firm grows, the value of their investment also grows. On the other hand, lenders are those who don't want to take undue risk. They are quite happy to get a defined return, which we call as interest, but their predominant consideration is safety of principal. So therefore, lenders take steps to protect their principal by way of mortgage, hypothecation, guarantees, and so on. Now let's talk about how does it make a difference from the company's perspective, who is taking this money. From company's perspective, the investors who give the company money don't create an ongoing burden, because there is no contract which mandates the company to pay a certain amount of profit, what is called as dividend, which is the share of the profits. However, from the company's perspective, the burden is quite high. And of course, in one of the later videos, we'll discuss the concept of cost of capital. At that time, I'll give you more details about this. For now, we could say that investors do not have contractual entitlement. However, their expectation that the company flourishes and their investment multiplies is quite high, and that expectation becomes a reasonably high burden on the management. On the other hand, the lenders have a defined set of obligations, whether it comes to repayment of principal, whether it comes to payment of interest. The obligations are well defined and they are reasonably moderate as compared to the expectations of the investors. This may look a little odd, but that's really the case, and we will deal with this issue in a later video in greater detail, as I mentioned earlier, when we talk about cost of capital. So just to sum up, what is equity, what is debt? Equity is the money which is received from investors, and as that money is put to work, it results into profits for the enterprise. But not all these profits are distributed back to the share owners, and the undistributed profits also keep on accumulating in equity. This equity is also known as risk capital. They are the ones who take the highest risk. It's only because equity owners are willing to take risk that the lenders who provide debt are also willing to pitch in. Without equity owners, the lenders, the debt owners wouldn't come forward. Neither would the vendors come forward nor the employees. So equity therefore is known as risk capital. Debt, on the other hand, simply means this is a borrowing from the company's perspective, which is yet to be repaid to lenders, and therefore it is called as debt. It has an obligation in terms of payment of interest, which the company has to pay on an ongoing basis. Friends, I hope this video clarified to you the two concepts of equity and debt. I look forward to your continued participation. Thank you.